嗨，大家好，我是李贝。OK，这次的视频我想，继续学习这个吧，做那个练习题，就是练习册，练习，题第十五课。OK，如果你看了我光看了我上次的视频，那个第14课。这是我的分数，并不理想，对吗？56%。这类的分数不太好。过去的，你可以比较一下，就是之前的75可以，我可以接受那个吧。然后95、92，就是突然间就是56，我觉得哦。这怎么行？这怎么可能？所以，我开始就是在之前的一部视频里，我开始做这个练习题，然后就觉得有点为难，有点不舒服，所以我是那个我怎么说，取消了这个我的视频。今天早上我有我的中文课，我跟我老师讨论这个问题。老师很好奇，这是一个那个个别的现象呢。我跟他练习这些问题，他就承认，第14课里的词汇，问题很难，词汇，还包括很多超纲词，所以不一定错在于我。所以我会试一试，学习这个吧。但是也因为这个上次的视频的不良表现，我觉得我有点不舒服。不知道。甚至我开始，以至于我开始学习这个吧。我写了第14课，也许我会回去彻底学习课文这个课文。我有点现在有点担心。OK，我们开始做练习题，听力部分。
第15课，山脉上的雕刻。一、听力。
Alright，我已经
第
准
一
备了。
部分。第1到5题，请选出与所听内容
OK，
一致的一项。
皇帝也
现在开
成语，
始第1题。
避暑。
一，
1768年7月下旬，酷热笼罩着大地。紫禁城里，人们开始为皇家一年一度前往承德避暑山庄的转移做准备。在那里，有一片按照江南风格与神韵巧妙设计而成的园林。坐落着富有南方情调的豪华宫殿，以及令人赏心悦目的亭台楼阁。
Yeah, I got nothing. there was a 皇帝。They mentioned 承德。承德 is a city in China. 皇帝要去承德避暑了。I don't think that's correct. 七月的北方气候是舒适，maybe。避暑山庄的宫殿十分简朴。I am guessing not. It's a palace. I don't know. 紫禁城里有一片美丽的园林。I think this is one of the ways of saying Forbidden City. Maybe it's the only way, actually. It's Forbidden City in Beijing. I honestly don't know. Let's go B. I've got nothing. But the purpose of this, because I got a terrible score last time. The purpose of this is to figure out whether or not that last time was or was not a once-off. 牛儿是个科学家，牛儿是个飞行员。Scientist pilot 付出了心血。This is not literal.
二，雏燕放飞的时候终于到了，
为了这一天的到来，女儿的老师、朋友以及我先生、我和女儿本人都付出了许多心血，这些心血已经变成女儿起飞的动力，使她能够展开翅膀，飞翔在全球资本市场的上空。
Okay, I think I got a lot of that, but is this one, is it? 很多人付出了心血。I think I heard that. Like, they listed a whole bunch of people. 很多人来庆祝女儿。Could be this one. 科学家。Was she fair? Okay, she wasn't a scientist. 飞行员。Maybe she was a saint. Okay, I'm going to put C, and I'm going to put D because I could be D. All right, next one. 她喜欢旅游途中读书。她喜欢读与旅游相关的书。
喜欢旅游是因为她想放眼世界。在旅游中体验行千里路胜读万卷书的乐趣。喜欢烹饪是因为他想用美味佳肴奖励辛勤工作之后的自己，同时也为亲朋好友献上在餐厅里吃不到的美女私房菜。
Alright. Okay, I don't know what this is relevant. This has any relevance at all. 他有一家自己的餐厅 MaybeOkay, 他喜欢读与旅游相关的书。他喜欢做出美味与朋友共享。Oh, maybe it's D. I think it's D. It could be B. No, I'm not sure. All right, next, 李小龙。李小龙就是 Bruce Lee.
李小龙是一个神话，他以原本并不优秀的天赋自创截拳道，并成为影响世界的一代功夫巨星。他可在拍出多部影响世界的功夫电影的同时著书立说，他惊人的毅力和坚韧的品格都已成为后人无法复制的神话。
Is it this one?有书出版 No, I don't think so. He's a movie star, right? Kung Fu movie star. 李小龙口才很好 I don't think so. 美人想复制李小龙复制复制 is different to 模仿 right? 复制 is like photocopy, right? Many people want to photocopy Bruce Lee. I don't know.十分有天才天赋 I think it's C. I'll listen a second time later and see what happens. 学科产生的社会发展的必要学科
很显然一些学科所以能够产生存在和发展是因为它对于社会人类有着自己的功能和价值这种功能价值一旦消失，这门学科便会失掉存在的意义，便会或迟或早的枯萎，直至被取消。
All right, I'm very close to choosing B. 学科存在的前提是对社会有用。Yeah, I think so. 学科的功能价值迟早会消失。Oh, absolutely no. 随着社会的发展。将不再区分学科。学科产生是社会发展的必然。No, I'm going B. I feel fairly comfortable that that's B. All right, the next part, the interview. Here you go. Now let me stop.
第二部分，第六到十题。
请选出正确答案。
因为能够认
识多的第六到十题。
What's this？ 对未知的
第六到十题是根据下面一个采访。好，现在坐在我身边的是旅行家郑先生。郑先生您好。
郑先生
您好，我不是什么旅行家，只是喜欢旅行，
或者说是喜欢旅行在路上的感觉。
对，这个贴切。旅行在路上不仅能让你陶醉于风景，更重要的是体验人与人的沟通，忘却自己的身份，去和来自不同地方的人面对面交流，这是我最喜欢的。
听说您尤其喜欢搭车旅行。
是，因为异样的旅行方式会带你感受不一样的风景。
搭车旅行是最近才兴起的吗？
不，国外早就有，中国是前几年美籍华裔小伙和纪录片导演刘畅两个人历经三个月，从北京出发到柏林，一路上只依靠陌生人的帮助，共搭车88次，走了16000多公里，穿越13个国家。这件事在中国传开之后，很多人开始搭车旅行。
碰上的都是未知的，我们不禁会对未知产生憧憬和向往，
也会充满惶恐，因为不知道自己该如何踏出勇敢的第一步。
能跟我们分享一下您记忆最深刻的搭车旅行吗？
那就是去西藏了。
冒险加神秘感？
不是，是西藏的壮美让我震撼。我那次运气特别好，搭的是一位藏族同胞的车，他是做生意的，我搭他的车几乎跑遍了我计划中所有想去的地方。
乘专车了？
嗯，他说一个人开车也闷得慌，有我一路聊天，他还能跟我练练普通话。我们第一天是从拉萨去林芝，一路上抬头是蔚蓝的天空，漂浮的白云，远望是牧民、草场和牛羊等牲畜，天上偶尔有老鹰盘旋。翻过米拉山，汽车开始在山谷间行驶，山上有泉水、瀑布，在峡谷间汇集成小溪，随着水量的增加，小溪汇聚成了江河，最后成了汪洋一片。那天的行程是我最有感悟的一天。
感悟什么呢？
感悟
不积小流，无以成江海。
是啊，就像滴水穿石一样，积累的作用不能小看。
六，男的为什么喜欢旅行在路上的感觉？
Why？ 因为能够认识更多有身份的人。错。因为别人能告诉你哪里风景好。错。因为能与众不同，与不同的人面对面交流。错。因为能够理解各地的风土人情。Maybe this one。能告诉你呢，面对面交流。I don't know. Let's go D. I feel like I understood a fair amount of what he said, what they were saying. 每个人在中国，美国人在中国，经常搭车旅行。很早以前，中国人就搭车旅行。So this is 中国人 in general, or is it that particular 中国人？三个月以前有人尝试搭车旅行，古月流畅的搭车旅行影响了中国人。I don't know these people. Did he talk about them? Maybe. I don't know. I just don't know. I guess I missed it.I'm going to go with C or D. I think they're the likely ones. Oh, I didn't listen to the question. That would explain. All right, well, listen to the question. That would explain something. But it's probably not going to change anything.
一，关于搭车旅行，下列哪项正确？
Yeah, all right, that didn't change anything. 对，未知的神往。I don't know this word.对已知的期待，对 艰辛的恐惧，对，能工的
搭车旅行的魅力是什么？
搭车旅行的魅力是什么？ Maybe this one。对能力的提升。No, I don't know. I think A, but I don't know what 神王 means. So 神王 like 神王 if it means something other than like.I don't know, the unknown future. then, yeah, it's not going to work for me. Maybe these two I'll do all right on. This one. Chodu. Yeah, he was from Tibet and he loved to chat. So I'm good. I'm pretty sure it's C.
关于男的在西藏搭车的经历，下列哪项正确？
Yeah, he's like,Tibetan ethnic minority, pretty much these other things, but I should know. he's from Tibet.
男的在西藏有什么感悟？
西藏的生态环境很好，西藏的江河湖海很美。Maybe this one. 一路的景色自然淳朴，积累的作用。不能小看。Oh, no, it's D, right? 积累的作用。This 积累。It's 经历积累的作用。This 作用 is not like applications, but more like usefulness or value. 不能小看。Which one do you reckon, B or D? I'm going to go D because that's what I think the answer will be.I'll listen a second time later. 然后第三个 MP3?
第三部分第十一到十七题
All right, what do we got here?
请选出正确答案。
地球、人类、
现在开始第十一到十三题。第十一到
地球生态超载日。
地球生态超载日又称生态越界日或生态负债日。地球生态超载日指的是根据估计地球当天进入了本年度生态赤字状态，即地球上全部人类活动的总消费量已超出了地球本年度产生的可再生自然资源的总量。我们的地球就像失去了尾巴的壁虎，本来是可以恢复原貌的。它可以让植物再生长，可以恢复鱼类资源，重新吸收空气中的碳，让干净的水重回湖泊、河流和地下蓄水层。但这些过程需要时间。自文明发祥以来的很长一段时间，地球补充资源的速度快于人类消耗资源的速度。然而，我们最终还是跨过了那条看不见的界限。从1970年起，我们每年从地球获取的资源开始超过其可以恢复的资源。自那以后，地球生态超载日就一路狂奔，不可阻挡。2015年的8月13日，它就已经来了。
十一，地球生态超载日意味着什么？
Okay, it's like a World Environment Day. 超载日。Not quite sure. 超载日，生态已经入不敷出，入不敷出。I don't know what that means. 入不敷出，言敷敷 ，it's 敷衍的言敷，入不敷出。地球资源已尽枯竭，地球已。无法再制造资源。人类对再生资源利用不够。I'm gonna go A. I don't really know what it means. Yeah. Next.是取之不尽的。那、地球修复是需要时间的。
说话人举壁虎的例子， 主要想说明什么？
To be honest, I didn't realize he brought up a 壁虎的例子。污染的水无法自行净化。I don't think it's that. 壁虎的自愈能力非常强。壁虎 isn't 壁虎 like a drawing on the side of a wall? It's not an actual tiger, right? 自愈能力非常强。取之不尽的。污染的水无法自行。I don't know. I'm going leaning towards D, but I really don't know. I don't know. I just don't know. And next, 地球补充资源的速度变慢了。地球的修复时间越来越快了。不好。
十三，人类活动造成了怎样的后果？
后果 it implies it's a bad thing. So humans are causing what problems? 地球生态超载日。So these just don't seem relevant to answering the question. This is about this 超载。Okay, 超载日 is probably... Oh, 超载日。Okay, this is overloaded.So, Earth Ecosystem Overloaded Day. 不好计算了。Okay, 地球补充。Yeah, that's my light. Alright, don't worry. I should just throw my light away. 速度变慢了。This is just not true, right? So it must be B. 修复时间越来越快了。修复实现原来地球生态超载日不好计算了越来越提前了 actually maybe this is like a tipping point like an environmental tipping pointSo this would make sense. This tipping point is being brought forward and forward. 不好计算呢。This is also a thing, maybe. Let's go back and look at this one. 已经 alright, so I now understand what they're talking about. That's what it is.It's a day when, just, I'm going to sneeze. Why is it? Yeah, it's a day when all the resources are used up or past the point of no return or something like that. I'm just overloaded? Yeah.So, let's go C. I'm not sure. I really, this is really hard for me. All right, next, we're talking about the Silk Road. 路上, and 海上, 丝绸之路. Yeah, I kind of looked at these. 南方运送.
第十四到十七题.
Oh, there's a few places here.
是根据下面一段话.
新疆西安.
丝绸之路.简称丝路，是指西汉时张骞出使西域开辟的，以长安（今天的西安）为起点，经甘肃、新疆到中亚、西亚，并连接地中海各国，通往欧非大陆的陆路通道。中国是丝绸的故乡，在经由这条路线进行的贸易中，中国输出的商品以丝绸最具代表性。而输入的商品有玉石、珠宝、皮毛、香料、汗血马以及葡萄、黄瓜等农产品。19世纪下半期，
德国地理学家李希霍芬在1877年出版的《中国》一书中，将这条陆上交通路线称为丝绸之路。此后，中外史学家都赞成此说，沿用至今。除了上述的路线之外，还有一条在南北朝时期形成，在明末发挥巨大作用的海上丝绸之路，以及另一条在元末取代西北丝绸之路成为陆上交流通道的南方丝绸之路。十四，这段话中的丝路指的是什么？
指的是什么？陆上丝绸之路 ，right? I think it's got to be the land route, not the sea one.
十五
，What's the question?
说话人提到德国地理学家李希霍芬。主要想说明什么
Yeah, it's this one. That's a tricky question, right? So this is true, but it's not the answer to the question. This may be true, but not the answer to the question. The reason the speaker wants to talk about this is because the speaker wanted to describe the origins of the term Silk Road.Yeah, these are true, right? They're true, but they're not the answer to the question. Tricky, or... 新疆、西安、甘肃、中亚。
十六，丝绸之路的起点是今天的哪里？
西安。B. Okay, that was easy. 有了丝绸之路，中国才有了马匹。
根据这段话，可以知道什么
？I don't think that's correct. 中国出口商品中，丝绸影响最大。Maybe. 陆路 ，Yeah, do you like that word? 陆路 ，same syllable. 陆路 ，fourth turn. 陆陆路啊，陆路贸易通道啊，在当时更受欢迎。No, I don't think that's correct. 丝绸之路是贸易往来的唯一通道。No, okay, C and D are out. 出口商品中 could be this one. I think B is the most likely of the four. All right. Well, there it is. That was the listening one. The rest, I kind of just take my time. All right. Here's the reading section. 皮格马利翁，皮勒马利翁 ，this person 是古代塞浦路斯 ancient Cyprus 的一位善于雕刻的国王。I mean, it's correct. I think this is just the name of some.Cypriot? Some ancient Cypriot? Presumably is a king who is good at sculpting. 这天邻居家 What? 邻居家办喜事请我去写对联回来时一见钟午请我去 What? 请我去他们家写对联 Is it 写对联 or 画对联 or Because 对联 is like calligraphy, right? Maybe it's okay 回来时一进This jin is like 接近 It was nearly noon. 中午 Nearly 中午、Yeah, I kind of think it's okay. I can't see anything obviously wrong with that. 他的豌豆杂交试验历十七年 this 十 can be used like this. This is 元龙 What's his name? oh no, this is hybrid peas, not hybrid rice. This is, what's his name? Mendel, is it? Mendel? 他逐个地分析了数以万计的种子和植株。 I think that's okay. Shu. Yeah, sometimes shu is a bit more flexible than I've done in the realized in the past. Can you say shu qi nian? So lasted for 7 years? I'm not so sure that that's correct. But it could be, but it's a rare usage. So bean hybridization experiment. Li. Oh, li shi. This isn't, it's not shi, but it's li shi. Yeah, I don't know this word, but it could exist. I'm gonna have to take their word for it that it does exist. Juzo Tangwa Hanan Goat what? Hanan Goti Nianqing and Jiji Xing. What? 去做糖瓜, okay, making 糖瓜, like sugared or candied guá fruit, something like that. 很难勾起年轻人. Ah, okay, so the production of 糖瓜 is 很难勾起, it's difficult to 勾起, to arouse the positive, active interest of youth. 天天起早, 天黑不算, 还, 挣不了多少钱, 挣不了多少钱. So this is 还挣不了多少钱. This is still cannot earn very much. 天天起早, wake up early, right? 起早, 贪黑, this is like stay up late as well. 不算. Yeah. I don't see any obvious errors in any of them. 这个人, 皮革玛丽翁, 是古代这个地方塞浦路斯的一位善于雕刻的国王. I think that's fine. I mean, maybe these kind of transliterations are not correct for some reason, but I can't. That's not usually the kind of questions they ask. 这天邻居家办喜事，请我去。 请我去. No, I think this 去 is wrong. It's 请我来叠对联, right? 去. Yeah, because the subject 请我去. Is it from the speaker's perspective or from the subject's perspective? Maybe it is 去. 请我去写对联. 回来时, 已近中午. Yeah, this one, should it be 来? 请我. 来，请我帮助写啊对联。嗯，他的挽救杂就试验历时七年。 I think that's correct. I'm not 100% sure. 他逐个的, actually this could be the error, because 逐个 is already an adverb and adding the 的 is not correct. 逐个分析,逐个, that makes sense. That makes more sense to me than this one. 请我去. Yeah, this I think can be interpreted as correct. 逐个的分析了数以, 就是数以万计的种子和植株。Yeah, so I think that's the most likely area then. 逐个的。去做糖瓜和能够起年轻人的积极性。天天起早贪黑不算。Oh, so this is if you don't wake up early and stay up late every day, you don't earn very much money. So it's manufacturing like candy, like toffee apples and other candied fruits, is hard to attract the interest of youth. All right, so that's the only thing. 逐个的, I think it's that. 逐个的。Alright, 下一个。每到开花季节，勤劳的蜜蜂到处采集花蜜，然后酿成蜜糖。Alright, I don't see anything wrong with that. Seems fine to me. 他是我们班学习最努力的学生，他，哦，我断定他大概会考上大学，断定大概 That may be an issue. 断定他大概大概OK, 大概 is a bit weird here, is it not? 大概Does 大概 mean probably? 很可能。大概会。Yeah. 断定。断定他大概会。It's a bit weird with 断定, so I 断定 I deduce or I infer that he...will probably get into university. 断定。断定 is also a bit strong as well. Like, 断定 means this is my decision. Whereas 大概 is kind of, I'm not sure. It implies an element of uncertainty. 这里环境优美。迷人的峡谷，装饰着四十个亿的色彩。Okay, I'm gonna assume this is actually a 成语 I don't know what. 令人流连忘返。流连忘返。All right, seems fine to me. 迷人 is an adjective. If you just in case you don't know, so okay.Like this enchanting fjord or something like that. Oh, yuan yang. Oh, it's yuan yang. It's a type of duck. Yuan yang. 既吃小鱼小虾和昆虫一类动物动物性食物，也吃谷物草仔等植物性食物。That seems fine to me. So I'm going to go B. I think 断定 with 大概 together, there's something wrong there. It could be that 大概 I'd delete the 大概 or maybe the 断定 is a bit weird. Just 我猜他很可能会考上大学 That's I'd say something like that. 大家过年的餐桌上曾经必备的一道菜还有蛋饺 Where's the 他家过年的餐桌上Wait, so this is the subject, right? 曾经必备的一道菜。So this is the subject of the sentence. 一道菜还有蛋饺。No, that's wrong, right? 曾经，也，I don't know, I can't make sense of it. It should be, it looks simple, but I can't make sense of it. I think that's because it's wrong. 具有锲而不舍追求真理的精神，是一个人走向成功的必要因素。因素 It, not 条件 not 前提因素因素 is a factor of why something happened. I don't think 因素 is correct. 必要的那个性质必要的而你是条件 yeah, 条件必要条件条件必备条件必要因素 Is this an 因素 I don't think so.It is a 条件我前提计划工作是为实现组织未来目前铺平道路的是为我其本身就具有前什么什么前什么性 OK what is 其 what is 其 referring to 计划工作是 OK so the act of planning work 是为实现组织未来目标铺平道路的I think that's OK其 this 其 is 计划工作本身就具有这个这个这个 whatever that is I don't know what that is that seems right to me 二十一世纪经济全球化的浪潮汹涌蓬勃蓬 inflation 金融一体化则 whatWait, 经济全球化的浪潮汹涌澎湃 maybe it's not that. So this is the verb. It's a Chengyu functioning as a verb, I think. 金融一体化则是经济全球化的关键 Why is there 则 here?Yeah, all of these look a bit weird to me.But this one seems completely wrong, right? 他家过年的餐桌上曾经必备的一道菜还有蛋饺。
That just seems like, what is it? I don't even know what it's trying to say, right? Is it just, 是蛋饺?This dish is this. Should it be shit? But this one, 因素 that's a bit weird to me too. That one seems alright. This one, I don't know. I don't see anything wrong. It just, it's not how I would write it. I think A is the most likely. 因素 maybe can be a bit more flexibly used than I was thinking. Oh. Sorry, I'm going to sneeze.All right. So, 天空okay, 温室效应 right? 现象 works. 效应 also works. No, it's 效应 greenhouse effect. All right, that's it. Haven't read anything else. It's B. Let's see if that would be correct.温室效应 greenhouse effect 温室效应使全球气候变得异常 works 特别 is special but it's a positive kind of special 异常 is abnormal
Fan Chang, that works. Xu Chang, that works. Yeah, so D is out. 许多地方发生干旱和洪涝。还要学冰山融化海平面升高。抬高 is not what you think. 抬高 is the opposite of 贬低别人，抬高自己。提升 is more like promote at work. 提高 maybe, but 升高 is better. It's B. But you know it's B because it's the first term in quotes is the greenhouse effect. 温室效应，就 that's it. You already know the answer. Yeah, quite honestly, if I was taking the exam, that would be enough.Yeah, just because you know the collocations. Like, it's the same in English, right? You say the greenhouse effect, not the greenhouse phenomenon, right? All right, next. 徐林是世界什么什么的风景名胜。世界第一 no, I don't know.珍惜 works. 拥有的 that's just, why would anyone say that? It's very, very weird. 罕见 is something that's seen rarely. It doesn't work here because 徐林is a particular place. Every time you go there, you will see it, right? So it doesn't make sense. 目主 is like a witness or something. It's not relevant. So I think the answer is A. 是大自然什么什么之作，出色可以经典。Oh, 经典 is classic. Doesn't work. This is outstanding. 鬼父 I have no idea what that is. Ghost axe? 鬼父 It is ghost axe, right?I don't know, I got nothing. 杰出 and 出色 are synonyms, so both of those work. 在广达400平方公里的区域内什么什么这上万个黑色大森林一般的巨石群maybe...排列 something like that. 漫步遍布充满遍及alright, I think 充满着 works. What is 遍及? I just don't know. 漫步This man, what is this man? It's not. I'm not sure. What does this man mean? 遍布 遍布 works. Doesn't it? Not sure. Okay, 有的独立场景，有的什么什么交叉，什么什么交叉 What's the collocation? I don't know.重叠交叉 That works. 犬牙 Dog teeth. Oh, this one, definitely. 纵横 So, even though I think 罕见 is wrong, I'm leaning towards D now. 时而有的独立成瘾有的时而交错 is like crisscross. It's got not really related to time. 时而 巨石群。So some of these stones form like scenery by themselves. Yeah. So 罕见的风景名胜。I guess it is. Usually 罕见 is something that you don't see rarely. You see rarely, you don't see often. 杰出遍布。Yeah, I feel like this fourth blank, 纵横交错. Yeah, that's a really good one. 重叠 is kind of okay, but do the stones like on top of each other? I have no idea what that is. I don't really know what that is. No idea what that is. 拥有, 拥有 seems wrong to me. you possess scenery? I'm going to choose D. I was not expecting this. Because I thought, surely it can't be 罕见. But this one seemed fine to me. This one seems to be the best choice for the last gap. 罕见, I think I can accept more than I can accept 时而. 时而 is with respect to time. 时而, 时而交错. But it's not like these giant boulders are like moving or something like that, so it doesn't make sense. Okay, 随着人口的增加和耕地面积的减小，对农业生产的要求越来越高，科学家必须什么什么更多高产。Maybe it's like 研究，高产优质抗病虫的动植物杂交种类。Okay, so they're using the word cultivate here. I think it's 培育. I think it's 培育. Well, 培育 is the word for cultivate. 养育, is that used for non-humans? 培养, 耕种. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure which ones are used in which context, but I think it's 培育. 品种 is variety, so you have different varieties of dogs. It's definitely 品种. 种类 is species. Yeah, so scientists aren't producing new species of crops, but are producing new varieties of the same species of crops. 产品 商品 Scientists are not producing 产品 and 商品. Alright, so I feel like it's definitely 品种. 品种 is varieties.Usually talk about different types of dogs, but in this case, it's different types of crops. Okay, 提供效率更高的高产优质生产率生产什么什么可持续可行性可利用可靠性 okay, 和更好保护保护的环保护地球环境的什么什么发展 this one 高产优质生产 生产技术 works 技能 capability not really 能力本领 and here yeah, 可持续发展 That's just a collocation, right? Sustainable development. Yeah, it's got to be A. All right, next is this one. Can you see it? I hope you can read it. I'm not 100% sure. I can make it bigger, but then it just cuts off. 世界文化遗产是一项由联合国发起联合国教育科学文化组织负责执行的国际公约建制以保存对全世界人类都具有杰出普遍性价值的自然和文化所文化无所谓目的什么什么什么什么 OK, we're starting a new sentence. 世界文物遗产属于世界遗产范畴。Maybe it's something like 这就是说。So here. 世界文化遗产是文化的保护与传承的最高等级。保护为合理保护和恢复 全人类共同的遗产做出积极的贡献。均有经联合国教科文组织审核被批准列入世界遗产名录的项目。Yeah. Okay, 参与世界遗产的 I don't know the character, 什么选管理与保护工作。I'm kind of expecting this to be relevant to people. 成立联合国教科文组织世界遗产委员会。Yeah, I think it's E, but I don't know. I think I should read on and then decide. 世界遗产分为自然遗产、文化遗产、自然遗产与文化遗产混合体及双重遗产文化景观遗产四类国际文化纪念物与历史场所委员会等非政府组织作为联合国教科文组织和协力组织。Maybe it's this one. Because I talked about 教科文组 and 均 meaning all.协力组织。均 works there.Well, I'm kind of expecting, because there's more than one item here, you'd expect to put a doll or something equivalent to a doll. Yeah, 等什么什么什么。Yeah, I think 25 is C.This has gotten substantially harder. 1972年联合国教科文组织在世界文化遗产总部巴黎通过了保护世界文化和自然遗产公约什么什么什么什么其宗旨在于促进各国和各国人民之间的合作。Maybe it's A. Okay, so this was 通过了 passed 成立联合国教科文组织世界遗产委员会。Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's A. And then Okay, 民间之间的合作为合理保护和恢复全人类共同的遗产做出积极的贡献。为 Yeah, I think that's fine.A little tricky, this one, isn't it? Yeah, I do still think the first one is E. So I haven't come to any complete disasters. 自 中华人民共和国在1985年12月12日加入保护世界文化与自然遗产公约的what is this 缔约国行列至今世界文化遗产、世界文化景观遗产、世界文化与自然双重遗产、世界自然遗产均maybe this one 也自从自 No, this is definitely C.Yeah, no, that last one must be C, right? So that one's wrong. Okay, I've done A, C, D. What is B? 参与. You can 参与这个. B works here. B doesn't work there. So let's say 25 is B. 参与. 参与 should be like people or a group of people.These other things just don't make sense. So 25 must be B. 参与. So, because a group can 参与. And the first one I thought was E. And that's the only one I got left. So I think it will do. Yeah, that was kind of tricky. All right, here we go. 三江并三江并流，自然保护区是世界上蕴藏最丰富的地质地貌博物馆。4000万年前 Whoa, that's a long time ago. That's 40 million years ago, right? No, yeah, 40 million years ago. 印度次大陆板块 so like the Indian secondary main plate or something like this. We're talking about tectonic plates here. 与欧亚大陆板块大碰撞 引发了横断山脉的急剧挤压隆声切割高山与大江交替展布形成世界上独有的三江并行奔流170千米的自然奇观。三江并流 So this is the three gorges, is it? The meeting of three rivers somewhere near the Indian boundary?三江并流是一个很大的区域准确的讲是指长江上游的金沙江湄公河 湄公 is the Mekong River 湄公河上游和蓝沧江以及怒江三条大江的并流区域三江并行奔流穿越于what's that? Tall mountain 峻岭之间形成世界上罕见的江水并流而不交汇 Okay, so there's 罕见 describing scenery. so maybe it can also mean like seldom in number, few in number. Okay, 奇特自然地理景观三江并流地区东亚南亚的和青藏高原三大地理区域的交汇处是世界上罕见的又是罕见 罕见的高山地貌及其岩画的代表地区。岩画 and its evolution 也是世界上生物物种最丰富的地区之一。三江并流自然保护区总面积3500多平方公里。景观主要包括三江并流、高山雪峰、峡谷、县滩、林海雪原、冰石湖泊、广阔美丽的雪山花面、丰富的珍稀动植物、独特的民族风情等。同时该地区还是16个民族的居住地，是世界上罕见，又是罕见。 OK, so we have to accept 罕见 can talk about, oh, here it's people, 罕见的多民族、多语言、多罕见的多 interesting 的多种宗教信仰和风俗习惯并存的地区。 Okay, so this is a rare example of multi-ethnicity, language, religion, customs coexisting. 是一块令人神往，又是神往。 What is 神往? I don't know. 令人神往。But if it 令人神往, it wasn't what I thought it was before. 处女景区。Alright, what is 神往? Alright, what are the questions? Okay, 关于三江并流的行程，下列哪项正确？是横断山脉断裂的结果，是大陆板块碰撞的结果。 Yeah, exactly this one. 是江水喷流冲聚的结果，是人 no 人为 people had nothing to do with it. It existed before people existed, right? But basically, what is it? It's C. It's the clash of tectonic plates. 三江并流的奇特之处在于okay, 三条大江都很长。三条大江都发源于长江。错。三条大江都很有名。
No, at least two of them are 有名。This one is famous. This one is definitely famous. But it's not really relevant to the question, is it?
奇特之处。
What makes them distinct?
三条大江并行而不交叉。
Maybe it's just this one. The three rivers are very long. I mean, that's true.
San Tiao Da Jiang.
Yeah.
Jiang Shui Bing Niu Er Bu Jiao Hui.
Oh, no, this one. This is. Oh, sorry. This one. It says it here.
的奇特眼
so it's D.
关于三江并流，下列哪项正确？哪里的景观非常壮丽？
I mean, yes. Is that not correct? That absolutely is correct, right?
那里的动物种类为世界最之位
no
为世界之最
no this is one of these things it's got a G right G does not mean the top. You delete the G if it was the top. It's probably like second or third or something. Could be. 那里的生态保护 做得不好. Alright, so you know that this is not going to be the answer to the question, because you never get questions that criticize like China, unless it's... Or, no, you almost never get questions that criticize China. So not that one. But it didn't say that anyway. 那里的百姓居住在 16个区域. No, it should... 同一个... No, it's 十六个民族. Yeah, it's completely mixing up all the things. It's the first one, which is kind of weird because it's the simple one, but all right. All right, what is 处女景区? 尚未开发的景区? No. 女人比男人多的... Obviously not. It's a metaphor. 神仙都想去的景区? Maybe. 处女. What is 处女? 美系民族文化尚存的景区? No. 母系. What is 母系? 母系. 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 All right, definitely not B and C. No, sorry, definitely not C. No, definitely not C and A. Is it B?
神仙都想去的景区. 令人神往.
I think this is meant to be a trick, right? The 神 in 神往. Really doesn't have any relation to like gods. So I'm gonna go D. I feel like that's meant to be a trick. It's like, does this have any relation to gods? No. But I don't know what Musi means, so seems like it has just gotten harder.
Okay. 1981年, 法国创设最美香精品牌. Alright, 至今已有157个 古镇被 列入法国文化遗产保护范围. 有着1000多年历史的古镇 被佛龙.
So this is the name of a French town.
就是最美 乡村之一. Okay. 为保持原生态这个地方严格控制商业用房的开发数量至今依旧只有一家面包店一家小超市和为数不多的几家咖啡馆与餐馆虽然生活不太方便 但保护与开发的平衡发展与这个地方赢得了生机.
Vitality, right?
也给村民带来了实实在在的好处.
Oh, I feel like going there now. Sounds really nice. Do you want to go to France? I've been to France. I went to Marseille. I went to Marseille and ordered mussels. They gave me so many. It's like a bucket of mussels. Whoa. Yeah, in Australia, they're very expensive. And here, I just don't eat them.
Okay, 英国古城镇的保护与19世纪兴起的历史文化遗产 立法运动息息相关. 古迹保护法令, 城市规划法令, 及国际法令 blah, I'm tired, 等多的等多部专门的法律法律规向向地出台根据这些法律规定凡是1840年前的凡是这一年前的建筑物都要加以保护不得更改外观。OK, 在德国保护修复甚至重建古城和古代建筑很少引发德国公众大讨论。二战后德国人德国人努力按照原想修复和重建历史建筑由此形成的老建筑无不以假乱真。All right. 无不以假乱真。They're all, I don't know what that means. 为保护和修复古建筑以及古镇德国政府积极采取措施吸引投资者参与同时通过立法约束确保古建筑保护到位。中国古镇的发展保护热潮早已席卷全国除了乌镇、丽江、凤凰这些游客早已耳熟能详的古镇外。So this is familiar to people's ears. 四川的丹巴藏斋 I don't know that place. 几百幢明珠依山旧事融于自然之中体现了天人合一的理念。新疆的图瓦村环境优美。四周山清水秀充满着古朴的原始色彩。云南的哈尼村落在美丽的田园之中与梯田庄稼相依和相携。如同仙境一般腾冲的和顺古镇有清代民居100多座风光如诗如画被誉为中国古代建筑的画那活化石。Alright. There, that's pretty intense. Lots of... Okay, first of all, there's a lot of words that are kind of... Like the names of places. Then they use all these flowery adjectives to describe these places. Which makes it even harder. And all it usually is saying is, there's a beautiful place here. 法国的这个地方。开发中避免了过度商业化 kind of 生活不方便阻碍了他的发展只为村民想不为游客想 在保护与开发之间经常摆在摇摆。I think it's A, right? They avoided excessive overdevelopment. Oh, I'm getting tired. 在英国，开展了古镇保护的讨论，曾兴起历史文化遗产立法运动，就城市建设有一系列法令，1840年前的建筑物可以更改外观。Is this one right? 不得 Oh, it's not that one. 不得 So one's older than this, you can't alter the exterior. Okay, fair enough. So not that one. So the series of links. 旧城市建筑。英国古城市的I don't know. That doesn't seem right, but it's not easily contradicted. 开展的古镇保护的讨论。开展的古镇保护的讨论。开展。No. 曾兴起历史文化遗产立法运动。Actually, it's this one, right?So this series of laws, yeah, in the 19th century, in the 1800s. This one. 运动. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's C. Let's go C. Getting tired. 德国的老建筑都是假的。Could be. But, no, surely not. Germany surely has some old buildings. 全部由投资者参与修复。修复后一点痕迹不露。通过立法决定是否进行保护。So with the German ones, they said this one.So after the World War II, the Germans 修理和 so strive to repair and like repair and renovate or and restore historical buildings. 由此形成的老建筑无不以假乱真。I think that does imply 都是假的。无不 There's no exceptions. 无不以假乱真。I think that's what it means. Not necessarily by investors. 政府 Yeah, no, it's the German government. So C is out. 修复后一点 Like, they didn't say anything like this, right?Like, it wouldn't be restoration or etc. if it didn't look something like the original. This is my Chinese teacher leaving me messages. 通过立法法定是否进行保护。I don't know. There wasn't anything about...、 立法决定, legal decisions, 同时通过立法约束. No, there are government restrictions on, like, protecting these things. You can't just do whatever you like. All right, so I think it's... Oshijada. I mean, really? Nothing survived World War II? Maybe. I mean, it was pretty awful. What am I... So it could be. I mean, I meant to do what it says in the text. Oh, okay, this one. This is familiar to the ear, right? This one. 耳熟能详. 熟能生巧. No. 耳闻目睹. 轻而易举. 在于互晓. Could be this one. I'll just have a look. Okay, so these cities... 这些... 游客早已这个古镇外. All right, so it's definitely not A and B. We'll get rid of those entirely. Is it C or D? 家喻户晓. 家喻户晓, I don't think you can narrow the scope. I don't think you can say this is 家喻户晓 among mathematicians. I think 家喻户晓 is everyone knows about them. Like 周杰伦, 他是家喻户晓的歌手, 对吗? Arwen Mudu. Yeah, I think it's C. Arshu Nungxiang. I don't know why it's Nungxiang. C. Alright, I'm tired. I'm getting tired and tired. Yes, we'll do the listening again.
第十五课. 山脉上的腰,
I'll switch to green and I'll make corrections if I feel like it.
听力, 第一部分,
these are my answers. I chose B.
七月的北方气候叙事现在开始第一题.
Okay, so is it B?
1768年7月下旬，酷热笼罩着大地，紫禁城里。 人们开始为皇家一年一度前往承德避暑山庄的转移做准备，在那里有一片按照江南风格与神韵巧妙设计而成的园林，坐落着富有南方情调的豪华宫殿以及令人赏心悦目的亭台楼阁。D.
Yeah, so one of the issues was they mentioned this and this, but they mentioned them far apart. So you got to pay attention to what the scope is talking about. Two.
二,
I chose C.
雏燕放飞的时候终于到了。为了这一天的到来，女儿的老师、朋友以及我先生、我和女儿本人都付出了许多心血。这些心血已经变成女儿起飞的动力，使她能够展开翅膀，飞翔在全球资本市场的上空。
Oh, so the flying is metaphorical. All right, so it's absolutely C, right? So I think it's C.
三。喜欢旅游是因为他想放眼世界，在旅游中体验行千里路、胜读万卷书的乐趣。喜欢烹饪是因为他想用美味佳肴奖励辛勤工作之后的自己。 同时也为亲朋好友献上在餐厅里吃不到的美女私房菜。Could
be B. Let's pause for a second. I don't know. So they talked about 餐厅, but it's not necessarily her 餐厅, it's just a 餐厅, right? 李小龙.
李小龙是一个神话。他以原本并不优秀的天赋自创截拳道，并成为影响世界的一代功夫巨星。他可在拍出多部影响世界的功夫电影的同时著书立说。
他惊人的毅力和坚韧的品格都已成为后人无法复制的神话。
So, 复制 is kind of like copy. I think it's that, right? These didn't get mentioned. This just seems wrong.
五，
很显然，一些学科所以能够产生、存在和发展，是因为它对于社会、人类有着自己的功能和价值。这种功能、价值一旦消失，这门学科便会失掉存在的意义，便会或迟或早的枯萎。
All right, I still think it's B, right? 消失, no, just doesn't mean the right thing. All right, so the next one.
第二部分，第六到十题，请选出正确答案。现在开始第六到十题。第六到十题是根据下面
一个DCABD。
大家好，现在坐在我身边的是旅行家郑先生。郑先生您好。
您好，我不是什么旅行家，只是喜欢旅行，
或者说是喜欢旅行在路上的感觉。
路
上，这个贴切。旅行在路上不仅能让你陶醉于风景，更重要的是体验人与人的沟通，忘却自己的身份。去和来自不同地方的人面对面交流，这是我最喜欢的。
听说您尤其喜欢搭车旅行。
是，因为异样的旅行方式会带你感受不一样的风景。
搭车旅行是最近才兴起的吗？
不，国外早就有。中国是前几年，美籍华裔小伙古月和纪录片导演刘畅两个人历经三个月，从北京出发到柏林。一路上只依靠陌生人的帮助，共搭车88次，走了16000多公里，穿越13个国家。这件事在中国传开之后，很多人开始搭车旅行。
碰上的都是未知的，我们不禁会对未知产生憧憬和向往，
也会充满惶恐，因为不知道自己该如何踏出勇敢的第一步。
能跟我们分享一下您记忆最深刻的搭车旅行吗？
那就是去西藏了。
冒险加神秘感，
不是，是西藏的壮美让我震撼。我那次运气特别好，搭的是一位藏族同胞的车，他是做生意的，我搭他的车几乎跑遍了我计划中所有想去的地方。
乘专车了？
嗯，他说一个人开车也闷得慌，有我一路聊天，他还能跟我练练普通话。我们第一天是从拉萨去林芝，一路上抬头是蔚蓝的天空，漂浮的白云，远望是牧民、草场和牛羊等牲畜，天上偶尔有老鹰盘旋。翻过米拉山，汽车开始在山谷间行驶，山上有泉水、瀑布，在峡谷间汇集成小溪，随着水量增加，小溪汇聚成了江河，最后成了汪洋一片。那天的行程是我最有感悟的一天。
感悟什么呢？
不积小流，无以成江海。
是啊，就像滴水穿石一样，积累的作用不能小看。六，男的为什么喜欢旅行在路上的感觉
？Yeah, this one. So, 搭车 was hitchhiking, right? He was hitchhiking among other countries as well, not just China.
七，关于搭车旅行。下列哪项正确？
Yeah, so let's. What did I chose C. I don't know. I don't know what D. How D is relevant. 很早以前，中国人就搭车旅行。每个人在中国经常搭车旅行。I don't think that's true.This is not true. I think C is the most likely. But the problem is I can't eliminate D. This one I chose A. I don't know what 玄王 means. Shall we look it up? Where's my phone?
八，搭车旅行的魅力是什么？
玄王。What do you reckon 玄王 is? 玄王。Wrapped. The true tradition.
关于男的在西藏搭车的经历，下列哪项正确？
This one I felt fairly confident. I chose C. I still think it's C. This one, so is it not? 西藏的江河湖海河。
男的在西藏有什么感悟？
It could be D or it could be B. What do you think? 生态环境很好。Yeah, honestly, I don't think I can get rid of any of them, really. I'll just leave it alone. I chose D, but I think that's the intended answer.And the last MP3, and then we'll just go through and mark them.
第三部分，第十一到十七题，请选出正确答案。
Yeah, I chose that. I'm not sure what that even means.
现在开始第十一到十三题。第十一到十三题是根据下面
一
段话。
I chose this one.
地球生态超载日，又称生态越界日或生态负债日。地球生态超载日指的是根据估计，地球当天进入了本年度生态赤字状态，即地球上全部人类活动的总消费量已超出了地球本年度产生的可再生自然资源的总量。我们的地球就像失去了尾巴的壁虎，本来是可以恢复原貌的，它可以让植物再生长，可以恢复鱼类资源，重新吸收空气中的碳，让干净的水重回湖泊、河流和地下蓄水层，但这些过程需要时间。自文明发祥以来的很长一段时间，地球补充资源的速度快于人类消耗资源的速度。然而，我们最终还是跨过了那条看不见的界限。从1970年起，我们每年从地球获取的资源开始超过其可以恢复的资源。自那以后，地球生态超载日就一路狂奔，不可阻挡。2015年的8月13日，它就已经来了。
十一，地球生态超载日意味着什么？
Yeah, I remember this. It's a point of no return, like an environmental point of no return. 地球已无法再制造资源。Oh no, not that one. I chose A. 入不敷出. So enter but cannot go back, or maybe something like that. 地球资源已尽阶段. I think it's not like that. It's more like, yeah, I don't know. I'll have to look it up afterwards, maybe. 人类对再生利用不够. I don't know.Some sort of point of no return. 壁虎. Yeah, I didn't pick up on the 壁虎 analogy here either. Here I chose D.
说话人举壁虎的例子，主要想说明什么？
I got nothing. 12. Yeah, I got nothing. I just don't know.
十三，人类活动造成了怎样的后果？
造成了。So it can't be this because it just doesn't answer the question. This could be D. What did I choose? I chose B. Wait, no, I chose 13. I chose C. Oh, I chose C.No, it doesn't. That's not an answer to the question. It's just not an answer to the question. Why did I choose C? 地球的修复是地球补充的变慢了。No, it must be D. It's the tipping point is getting closer and closer, or this point of no return, because of like man's actions.All right, so we went next is the Silk Road.
第十四到十七题
是根据下面一段话。
A.D.
丝绸之路，简称丝路，是指西汉时张骞出使西域开辟的，以长安（今天的西安）为起点，经甘肃、新疆到中亚、西亚，并连接地中海各国，通往欧非大陆的陆路通道。中国是丝绸的故乡，在经由这条路线进行的贸易中，中国输出的商品以丝绸最具代表性，而输入的商品有玉石、珠宝、皮毛、香料、汗血马以及葡萄、黄瓜等农产品。19世纪下半期，德国地理学家李希霍芬在1877年出版的《中国》一书中，将这条陆上交通路线称为丝绸之路。此后，中外史学家都赞成此说，沿用至今。除了上述的路线之外，还有一条在南北朝时期形成，在明末发挥巨大作用的海上丝绸之路，以及另一条在元末取代西北丝绸之路成为陆上交流通道的南方丝绸之路。14，这段话中的丝路指的是什么？
丝路 ，It's gotta be this one. Yeah.
15，说话人提到德国地理学家李希霍芬主要想说明什么
？Yeah, so she wants to explain this. These are true, but it's not the answer to the question. Xinjiang, yeah, this is the start of the Silk Road in ancient times.
16，丝绸之路的起点是今天的哪里？
西安。And I chose B. I think she said that too.
17，根据这段话，可以知道什么？
Yeah, I think that's right. Alright, I'm tired, but let's do this. There are my final answers for chapter 15. Get out the red pen. Are you nervous? I'm nervous. Oops. Now, here the answer is the answer book.Dun, dun, dun, dun. There are the answers. Let's see how I did. A. C. D. A. B. C. D. A. C. D. B. C. D. A. D. B. B.D, D, A, D, D, A, B, B, A, D, C, D, D, A, 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 C. What? A, C, B, D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.6, 7, 8, 9. What is 9? 36 on 27. Life in Jatishu, right? Go check. But they're both divisible by 9. Everything's divisible by 9, so that should be correct. So 27 on 36. Yeah, life in Jatishu. It's okay. Not ideal, but it's okay. It's bearable. Getting some of the writing ones wrong is a bit of a surprise for me. But maybe I just get tired towards the end. I don't know. I got the first one wrong. I said B, then I changed it to D, and then the answer was A. Okay. So the answer is...生态已经 No. Oh, the first one was really, really hard, though. 皇帝要去承德避暑了。Yeah, the first one was pretty hard. So I think I can just say, all right, that was hard and I can't do much about it. Okay, 1768年7月下旬，酷热牢笼罩着大地，紫禁城里，人们开始为皇家一年一度，前往承德避暑山庄的转移做准备。Yeah, okay, so there's the answer, isn't it? So the, not just the Huangdi, but the whole imperial family want to go to Chengde for the summer. 在那里有一片按照江南风格与神韵巧妙设计而成的园林。Yeah, so 在那里有园林，那里是哪里？那里是，紫禁城呢？那里不是紫禁城，那里是承德。他说，北京为北京的紫禁城到承德，皇帝是从那儿到那儿到那儿，他想避暑，那里有园林。紫禁城没有园林。Actually, I should know that, right? I've been to the Forbidden City. Yeah, there is no, like, forest in the Forbidden City. Yeah, actually, that is a fair point. I've been to the Forbidden City. I should have known that. All right, then I got 4 incorrect. Oh, Li Xiaolong?李小龙是一个神话。Okay, so this is a metaphor, right? He's a myth. 他以原本并不优秀的天赋。Oh, okay, there goes my answer. So he didn't have any exceptional talent, right? 自创截拳道。Oh, is that taekwondo?并成为影响世界的一代功夫巨星。他可在排出多部影响世界的功夫电影的同时著作立说。Yeah, all right, so he wrote a book. How many books did he write? 多部。He wrote several books. Li Xiaolong? Like Bruce Lee wrote books? Really? I mean, yeah, well, one of the answers was that. Can we Google this? I'm curious. So what books did... Oh, I gotta turn the VPN on. What books did...Did Bruce Lee write? okay, so he wrote books on about kung fu, right? 功夫，关于功夫的小说什么？ I did not know Bruce Lee wrote books. Bruce Lee Library. Books written by or about Bruce Lee.Okay, I had no idea he wrote books. So there you go. You can go buy Bruce Lee's books. All right. I wasn't expecting that. I just think of him as a kung fu movie star.Bruce Lee wrote books. Alright, fair enough, I got it wrong. So it's not only... I like questions like this because not only does the recording contradict my answer? All right. So, yeah, 并不优秀的天赋. Yeah, 原本, 并不优秀的天赋. 原本, originally, no, 天赋. That implies later on he had 天赋, though. Yeah, kind of, you can kind of infer that's not the anticipated answer. And it does quite literally say he, 他可在拍出多部影响世界的功夫电影的同时著书立说. All right, so these four characters, and that's it. That's everything you got. Yeah, that's it. You got those four characters. So while making kung fu movies, he wrote books. Yeah. All right, that was pretty hard. Four characters. All right. That, so seven, I wrote D as, I couldn't eliminate D, and it turns out D was correct. But I didn't hear these names, Gu Yue and Liu Chang. So let's have a look. Yeah. So, yeah, there's all sorts of things. Where did they get mentioned then? Sorry. Do you see him? So we are talking about question seven, right? Question seven, the answer was Gu Yue Liu Chang de Da Chu Lu Xing Ying Lu Xing Ying Xiang de Zhongguan. Was it at the start? Yeah, Liu Chang. Okay, Mei Ji Hua Yi Xiao Huo. Ah, Gu Yue. 和纪录片导演 Liu Chang 两个人历经三个月 历经三个月 从北京出发到柏林 一路上只依靠陌生人的帮助 共搭车88次. So did it influence Chinese people? 这件事在中国传开之后 很多人开始搭车旅行. Yeah, okay. It absolutely says that. Yeah, that was hard. Like, pulling this out, yeah, is hard. Fair enough. I got it wrong. 11. I got 11 and 12 wrong. So, 11 and 12. This one. 地球生态超载日. Okay, so this is Earth Ecosystem Overload Day. Let's just read it, because I'm actually kind of interested in what they actually said. 地球生态超载日, 又称生态超界日, 或生态负债日. Okay, Ecosystem Debt Day, something like that. 地球生态超载日 指的是, 根据统计, 估计, 地球, 当天, 进入了, 本年度生态赤字状态. Okay, 即地球上, 全部人类活动的总消费量已超出了地球本年度产生的可再生自然 资源的总量. Oh, okay, so I think I get it now. So every year the Earth can produce a certain amount of resources, the renewable resources. So there's a particular day in the year when that is used up. And because people are getting greedier, is it moving forward or backwards? Yeah. Okay, I got it now. That's conceptually a challenging thing to think about, I think. So I'm not too surprised I didn't get that answer, actually. Actually, two of them I got wrong. 我们的地球就像失去了尾巴的壁虎. Oh, okay. So it's a... What is bihu? Is bihu an actual tiger? Oh, it's a gecko. Ah, okay. So I didn't know this animal. Bihu, gecko. So you cut off the tail of a gecko and it grows back slowly. We're like... 是可以恢复原貌的，它可以让植物再生长，再生长，可以恢复鱼类资源重新吸收空气中的碳，让干净的水重回湖泊，河流的和地下蓄蓄处。 地下蓄水层 is an aquifer 蓄水层，但这些过程需要时间。 All right, I kind of get it now. Can I show you this bit? 自文化发扬以来的很长一段时间，地球补充资源的速度。 快于人类消耗资源的速度. Okay, so from the dawn of civilization, like the Earth was able to replenish resources faster than humans could consume them. 然而，我们最终还是跨过了那条看不见的界限. So we've now crossed the threshold. 从1970年起. From 1917, okay, so in the 1970s, we crossed the threshold. Humans are extracting more resources from the Earth than the Earth can produce.
自那以后，地球生态超载日是一路狂奔，不可阻挡。
2015年的8月13日 它就已经来了。 All right. So from the 1970s, that the threshold of which a year's worth of planetary resources are used up. A year's worth of the resources generated by the planet are used up. So, I got two of them wrong. And fair enough. Here. So, a choice B, the answer was A. 生态已经... Oh. Well, yeah, I chose A, changed it to B. Then. Okay, what does it mean? 入不敷出. Yeah, this is, I mean, I got this wrong because I don't know what that means. 入不敷.
Okay.
Okay. So this is your expenses are more than your income. And it's used metaphorically as well. So it's a 成语, it's an idiom. It's an idiom I have not encountered before, and it's an idiom, it has a literal meaning, but a figurative meaning as well. Here it's used figuratively. Okay, Yeah, all right, that was hard. And this one, 酷比的自愈能力非常强. So was that the answer? 12. No, the answer is C. 地球修复是需要时间的. Yeah, all right. I mean, yes, but I couldn't eliminate the other ones. I didn't really understand it, so it's unsurprising. Okay, writing section. I got the first 病问题中. So I chose C. The answer was D. I chose this one. The answer was D. 聚焦糖瓜. So this is the topic. 很难勾起年轻人的积极性. 天天早起贪黑不算. 还挣不了多少钱. So this seems fine. I don't know. Let's Google it. I don't see what's wrong with it. Oops. And we'll go read some Bruce Lee. okay. 制作糖瓜 很难 勾起. Okay, 勾起, I'm not so familiar with this word. This is the error. Okay, so they just got rid of the 不算. Oh, all right. So, the problem is these people who are asking questions on this website are not asking the same. So this guy forgot the 不算. So that's the problem. Has someone else asked the question who didn't make a typo? 不算. It's just this one. All right. 糖瓜很难勾起年轻人的积极性. So they think that the first part's fine. 天天 早起早贪黑贪黑还挣不了多少钱. So they didn't change it, right? Did they change it? They didn't change that part. Did they change even a single character? There is a character. Something's different here. 天天还挣不了多少钱。Why is it? It looks character for character identical. Am I missing something? That's fine. Oh, there's a space here. Okay, so they didn't change it. I don't know, because they inputted this one. 举出这两句子句话. All right, so this person has inputted the sentence but left off the 不算. Yeah, this one just doesn't make sense at all, right? But that one was easy, wasn't it? That was the easy one. Like, yeah, this is the subject. 一道菜还有蛋饺. But where's the rest of the sentence? Or I don't know, it's just incomplete. So maybe they've inputted it and gotten rid of the 不算, and that corrected the sentence. And maybe they thought that that was the error or something. I don't know. Can we look at your dao? What is bu suan? How is it used? Doesn't count, yeah. But can it be used at the end of a sentence like that? No, all right. Bu suan. All right. So it looks like that's the error. The bu suan. Yeah. So this is fine. This without the bu suan in this. The bu suan. Okay, so they just thrown in a random word in a random place. I don't know. I kind of took it on faith that they got that one correct. Bu suan. Yeah, I interpreted it as meaning Olun. Olun Jigger. Hai Jung Buliao. Alright. What did I choose? I chose C. Zhuge De. Yeah, I was a bit iffy with Zhuge De. But it seems Zhuge De is okay. Alright. Anyway, that's probably not the most important one. I only got 4 wrong in the reading section, that's alright. But usually, these ones are the easiest, because I read the whole thing. I got 32 wrong. 32, I chose D, the answer was A. Ah, what is Muxi? Yeah, actually, I don't know what that means. We could just look it up. This is 圣女的意思对吗？景区初女, so virgin scenery, scenic area. 尚未开发的景区. Oh, okay. Actually, maybe I should have known that. 初女. Yeah, I should have known that. What is 母系? What is 母系? Maternal. Matriarchal. 民族文化. 尚存的景区. So I got rid of that one. Why did I get rid of that one? 尚未发展的, no, 开发的景区. Yeah, I got rid of that one because it's like undeveloped region. I got rid of it because they talked about a region where there was like 16 ethnic groups. Yeah. 16 ethnic groups. And that counts as undeveloped? Yeah, all right. I feel a little bit swindled on that one. But this is clearly the wrong answer. This is what this means. So, I feel like they talked about how there was 16 ethnic groups and all, with all this going on in the same area, and this area counts as undeveloped. Yeah. Also, Shenwang. What is Shenwang? Still, Shenwang. 出生的盼望, something like that. 向往. Okay, 35 I got wrong. I chose A, the answer was B. B. 修复后一点痕迹不露. Okay, so after restorations, the buildings look the same as they were before. You can't tell the difference. 原样修复和是按照原样由此形成的这个吧. What is 无不以假乱真? 以假乱真. All right. Mix true. Yeah, all right. I feel like it's almost like a trap, right? So you don't see any traces of the prior to restoration. Yeah, all right. This is another one. It's like, here's a random Kyungyu you don't know. D. It is D. It is 家喻户晓. So 家喻户晓 among a certain group of people. Does it work like that? Okay. It probably just doesn't matter. 耳熟能详. 耳熟能详. All right. What's repeatedly heard can be repeated in detail. All right. But that's, is that 家喻户晓? I mean, 墓主. I don't know. It doesn't feel like 家喻户晓. 除了这些, so the problem with 家喻户晓 is I don't think you can limit the scope to a certain group of people. The 游客 in this example. 家喻户晓. Known to every household. 叶雷芳在中国家喻户晓. Everyone knows him. Doesn't matter what walks of life. I don't recall seeing it used, like, all right, so it's the last question. I'll just quickly ask ChatGPT, hey? I hope I don't have anything weird on the screen. What's that? I don't know. Oh, that's my writing. What was I doing? Can 家喻户晓 mean be used when restricted to a group of people like travelers? But I really don't recall seeing it ever used like that. 家喻户晓. So that's what caught, like, it doesn't. So, where do I begin? It's like the meaning of this is this vaguely. The meaning of this is vaguely 家喻户晓, but not in this context. Right? What are we talking about? What's frequently heard can be repeated in detail. Yeah, I don't know. Sorry, I forgot to switch over to this one. 耳熟能详. It's like, all too familiar. By the general public. So ChatGPT thinks 家喻户晓 can be used, but can you give me? So it can be used for a certain group of people, such as travelers. Yeah, I don't recall encountering that before. 家喻户晓. What's going on? I don't know. 家喻户晓. Yeah, household names. Would you say that's a household name among travelers? Yeah, it's a bit weird.
All right. So let us watch. Oh, whoops. I'll go to Poe. And are Shu Nung Xiang synonyms? Hey, who's and are Shu kind of feels different to me. Is Zui Xiang Jin de Shi. Okay, so I guess the textbook gets away with it by asking this one, the closest, the one with the closest meaning. And it would be fair to say this is closer in meaning to R Wen Mu Zhu, because the Mu Zhu is not really relevant. R Wen Mu Zhu is Zhu, right? Mu. Or is it Mu? Oh, I got that wrong. Yeah, maybe this is what the logic is. Maybe the mu du doesn't work. Nung xiang. All right, fair enough, fair enough. This, I think I do accept that this is closer in meaning to this. Mm. All right, I'm a little tired. I think I am going to have a rest. 75% on this one. It wasn't the disaster of chapter 14. I'm not sure. I have to think about what I'm going to do. All right. Let's call it a video. Remember to do the liking and subscribing and all the usual thingamajiggies. I'm going to have a bit of a nap, I feel. 谢谢大家, 我们下次聊。Bye-bye.